Hello chess lovers, Soren here, and in this video I want to share with you a very dramatic game where Soviet chess grandmaster Viktor Korchnoi saves a completely lost position and then strikes back. In this game Korchnoi's opponent is the 10th world chess champion Boris Spassky. Although Spassky would only earn the world chess championship title a year later, but meanwhile this is the 1968 Candidates Tournament Spassky-Korchnoi match. In this game Korchnoi had white pieces and he opened up with d4, to which Spassky responded with d5, c4, e6, Queen's Gambit declined is on the board, knight c3, bishop e7, black is going for Petrosian variation, c takes d5, e takes d5, bishop f4, c6, queen c2. I have to tell you that this line is very popular nowadays and can be seen very often even at the highest level, but in here the most popular move is e3. In the game we see queen c2, g6 and castling queenside. At the time this was a novelty. Nowadays f3 or e3 are considered to be more popular, but in the game Korchnoi decided to castle queenside, and this is actually a very risky decision. Bishop f5 can be always met with queen b3, that's why Spassky proceeded with the development of his kingside pieces with knight f6, f3, knight a6. Already white could meet bishop f5 with e4, in the game we see knight a6, but anyways e4 is on the board. Knight b4, queen b3, bishop e6, e5, knight goes back on d7, after which this time Korchnoi attacked the second knight, a3. And now if you move back your knight, then white can capture on b7. That's why Spassky's next move is like forced, and he made this powerful a5 move. He's making a piece sacrifice, and now once white accepts the knight sacrifice, black will rely on the vulnerability of the a file and will build up his attack. A takes b4, knight b1, the knight will now cover white king. c5, there comes the pawn storm, g4, in return white is starting a counterattack on the king side, and of course one thing is obvious, that d takes c5 is not good. Allowing black knight to jump into the game can be catastrophic for white, that's why to c5 we have g4 answer, and this time the c pawn stepped even further, c4, queen e3, rook a2, h4, queen a5. Rook h2. At this point Stockfish gives black -5 advantage. Rook a1. But the move which could allow black to finish up his opponent at the spot is knight c5. A very beautiful piece sacrifice, the idea of which is to announce a check from b3 and then go for a rook sacrifice. For example, let's just proceed with a counterplay, then knight b3 can follow, and then rook takes b2 check. And white king is getting checkmated, queen a1 followed by queen a2 checkmate. Or if you accept the piece sacrifice, then this time the dark squared bishop is managing to join the attack. If queen e2, then rook a1 followed by moves like b3 or queen h2, and this is a total destruction. In the game after rook h2, we see rook a1, bishop d3. So white is eager to give back the piece, but black is not interested in it. We have b3, knight e2, and bishop b4. Interestingly, at this point Mikhail Tal recommended c takes d3. If queen takes d3, then h5. But according to Stockfish, the strongest move is knight b6, followed by knight a4, and then sacrifice can follow. But in the game after knight e2, we see bishop b4, h5, white is proceeding with the attack, and finally Spassky castled kingside. It may seem that this is risky, but black's position still stands solid, h takes g6, f takes g6. Well, black is missing a very strong continuation, which starts with c takes d3. The idea is to open up the c file and target white king further. And now if g takes h7 check, then king h8, black can use this pawn as a defensive shield. If queen takes d3, then black can either announce a check from c8, and then yeah, black is winning white queen, the knight is pinned. Or at this point even rook takes b1 is winning. if queen takes b1, then rook c8 check, followed by bishop takes c3. But in the game after h takes g6, we see f takes g6. But still, even at this point, Spassky is maintaining advantage. Rook h1, c takes d3. Finally, black is winning this bishop. Queen takes d3, queen c7, check. Knight c3, and with his next move, black is making a terrible mistake, which is allowing white to equalize. Instead, it was better to play bishop takes c3. We will cover this line after seeing white's next move. So, the problem with knight b6 is that white has a very beautiful counter-attacking resource. As we have reached the critical position, please pause the video and try to find white's next moves. Ready? In here, Korchnoi played queen takes g6. Look at this beauty, guys. Relying on the vulnerability of black queen, queen takes g6 sacrifice becomes possible. But now, let's first cover the line starting with bishop takes c3, and then we will proceed with the game. So now, if a move like queen takes c3, then black can go for the exchange of queens and then can capture on f4. And yeah, black has an extra piece. The game is over. Or after bishop takes c3, if b takes c3, then simply rook takes f4. And now if you go for a move like queen takes g6, then of course accepting the queen sacrifice steps into a checkmate. That's why black should simply move his king to f8 square. And if queen h6 check, then king e7, the rook is untouchable because at least queen takes c3 with the mate to follow very quickly, and yeah, black is winning. Instead, in our game, knight b6 was played, and there comes queen takes g6. And now let's see what's the idea of this beautiful move. H takes g6, rook h8 check, king f7, rook h7 check, king e8, after which we first see the exchange of rooks on f8, and rook takes c7. White not only managed to equalize, also has a slight edge. But from psychological point of view, white has a huge advantage, you know. White managed to get out of the terrible position, which will now play a huge role in the game. Knight c4 was met with rook takes b7, bishop takes c3, b takes c3, b2 check, king c2, king e8, bishop g5, rook a6. A mistake by Spassky. This is allowing white to free his knight. Instead, it was better to play, for example, bishop d7. Instead, bishop g5 was met with rook a6. Knight d2, as there is no rook, there are no rook c1 checks. White is now managing to activate his knight. Bishop c8, rook e7 check, king f8, knight takes c4. White is exchanging the knights, is removing the defender, and is winning this dangerous pawn. White is already winning. Rook b6 check, king c2, bishop b7, and another beautiful move by Korchnoi. Can you find his next move? Ready? Well, this time he simply went for an exchange sacrifice. Rook takes b7. With his powerful pawns, he will now finish up his opponent. Rook h7, king b2, not allowing black to neutralize white king on the first rank, after which resignation followed. Yes, with this powerful pawn supported by the bishop, white can now quickly win the game. That's why at this point Spassky resigned. Spassky missed so many chances that this was fair that Korchnoi managed to strike back and win the game. That queen g6 move was very beautiful, and I hope that you enjoyed this game greatly. In the end, a chess puzzle for you, where the task is to find the winning line for white. I will wait for your answer in the comment section. Let's see, can you find Bobby Fischer's move? In the end, feel free to check out these suggestions as well. I will see you in my next video. Take care.